Meitei never indulged to any kind of violence, any kind of threats to any community. And the border has been kind of open. It's a 395 kilometer long international border sharing with Myanmar. The chief minister of Assam is struggling to control the menace of the drugs. Why all this suddenly start increased? Do you find any kind of report that there were kind of a violence? No.
Namaste, everybody, and welcome to Sangam Talks. Today, we have with us Sh Nabakishore Singh Yumnam ji, who is the National Spokesperson of World Meitei Council with us. And as we all know, the 2023 Manipur violence that has erupted and it's been going on, and there have been a lot of loss of life. But what are the core issues that we need to understand in depth? And for that, we have Nabakishore ji speaking with us today. Namaste, Nabakishore ji.
Namaste.
So Nabakishore ji, to begin with, I'll first of all ask you the question that this whole separation of the hill area and the valley, which was done by the British, basically to have a buffer between the Naga infiltrants and the valley Meitei people, does it have any relevance today and should it be done away with?
British has put this because of their kind of the convenient of their administration, but at the same time, what the documents, the British documents, they speaks out that in the valley and this hill area adjoining these areas, the British allowed or brought this Kuki community, precisely Sh Nabakishore community, to more or less control this Naga community, so that they feel that in their kind of the administration, that will be make them easier. However, the today's problem is, I think that is again very different, because the problem today we have is the basically an attack by an immigrant community, which again joined by more illegally migrant who came from, especially from Myanmar in the past few decades. And then also they have their militants group. Some of them are under suspension of operation, and jointly all this together, this time they have started attacking an indigenous community, which is Meitei. And to the world, looks like this 3rd of May, the first, this violence was erupted. It was in Churachandpur. And then after that, wherever the Kuki majority area, another is the Moray. The Moray is a town bordering to Myanmar. So there they have attacked all the Meitei houses. They have not spared anyone there. Even they have burned down all the temples, even the Meitei churches in Churachandpur. So this is sort of a well-planned, and they have this kind of thing much of ahead. And probably they have chosen this 3rd of May as per them as a strategic date, where they have sowed kind of a rally, they claim that solidarity march against the scheduled tribe status demand by the Meiteis. So they as a tribal, they who have already been enjoying the scheduled tribe status, they don't want Meitei to get this scheduled tribe status, and they started. However, in that rally, the video footage we could see is that there were militants holding AK-47, sophisticated arms and ammunition. They are also part of the rally. So we have a bigger question, that how come a peace rally can be accompanied by a militants group? And if you are really, really, you are having an objection to the scheduled drug demand by the Meitei, then why don't you go on the democratic process.
What you're saying, it makes all the more sense, because in April, the Manipur High Court instructed the state government to take a quick decision within 4 weeks on the demand by the Meitei people for scheduled tribe. So they kind of, you know, wanted to stall that at any cost.
This High Court order, this became a one of the kind of very misleading and also misinterpreted by various news media. In fact, our Honorable Chief Justice of India himself also misunderstood the order of High Court in the beginning. Okay. So consequently, there were a hearing on 17th of May in Supreme Court, where Honorable CJ himself took this case, and there he understood that the order was basically to respond by the government of Manipur to the Ministry of Tribal Affairs with the two reports. Okay, so the High Court did not say anything that the Manipur government to implement or something. It is just telling that for the pending for the past 10 years, these two reports has to be sent as a grievances made by the Meitei, one of the CSO. Then the High Court have instructed to release this or send these two documents without further delay within the 4 weeks time. Okay, so that has to be understood in the beginning.
What has been the history of the Meitei people and the Kuki and Zo tribal people? Has it been peaceful? Has it been good, or was it fraught with violence even before?
Meitei are one of the indigenous community. They are aboriginal inhabitants in the state of Manipur. Along with the Meitei, there are one more indigenous community. They were Naga. So as per the ancient history or the mythology, the Naga and Meitei used to live together. The Meitei king used to rule the entire Meitei kingdom, which is, in fact, it was a farther area than the what Manipur today. Okay, it was extended far beyond the kind of the geographical footprint we have today in Manipur. It was far beyond that. The Manipuri or the Meitei Raja or the king has to rule. And in fact, the mythology speaks out that the Meitei were also living in the hills together with Naga. Now, all of a sudden, where this Kuki came? As per the British data, as per the historical data, it speaks that the Kuki came into Manipur, especially from Myanmar, the Chin Kuki, in the 18th century. Okay, and they were mostly settled in the foothills. So basically that buffer zone which I have explained previously. However, later on, slowly, there were several Chin Kuki community people who entered in the hills, where the hill were sort of like a barren land. No one is there to monitor who is there, who is not there. Okay. So, and the border has been kind of open, porous. It's a 395 kilometer long international border sharing with Myanmar. So there is in fact, no one is to control that border. So gradually they have started coming and occupying those hill area also. Now, the point which you have mentioned, the Meitei and the Kuki, how was their relation? Okay, in fact, Meitei's relation with any of the community in Manipur was very peaceful and the harmony. Meitei never indulged to any kind of the violence, any kind of threats to any community. Okay, there may could be a small violence here and there that could be kind of the accidental or incidental, but in terms of a which we can call a kind of a violence at this degree, it was never happened. Rather, Kuki was always a troublesome in British political agent. Colonel Macula, he mentioned that this Kuki, this community, is one of the very barbaric community. They always engage kind of the bloody attacks to the neighbors. So historically, they were quite violent, they were quite aggressive. And 1993, even in the modern days, they attacked the Naga, who used to live quite together in the kind of hilly areas as well. And subsequently, they have also attacked 1997, one of the community called Meitei. And after 30 years from this 1993, when they attacked first Naga, in 2023, now they have attacked the Meitei. But there were quite a kind of a strategic when they made this attack to Meitei is a quite strategic one, because this time the illegal immigrant who entered in the large number from Myanmar, they started cultivating poppy in the hill areas. They have deforested in the bigger areas. Lots of hills have been deforested, and they have cultivated the poppy. And what from this poppy is basically the latex which is come out from this poppy flower that used to be extract the drugs or the heroines, whatever you call all this narcotic substance. And these drugs have been basically controlled by definitely a big kind of the drug lords, okay? And at the same time, the militants who were under the suspense of operation, okay? So there seems to be all in the joint hand in hand, and they made a plan that when this government of Manipur, when they have started destroying this poppy cultivation, then they understood that they can't do this kind of things, this illegal kind of things anymore. So they thought, is the time to create some disturbance so that out of this, they can claim that they were kind of attacked by the Meitei, so that they can frame a story. And now they are demanding a separate administration. It's just like they are demanding a separate state for them. Okay. Now, this is something which they have worked upon together, and finally they made a kind of a plan with the foolproof that they will achieve what they have thought.
The Kukis and the Zot tribes and 40% population, and they occupy 90% of the land of Manipur, and the Meitei people are around 53%. And they occupy only 10% of the land. And still the government has classified it as a state with hilly areas, not a hill state. What do you think is the problem with this, and what kind of land reforms are needed?
This 53% the population share is based on the 2011 census data. Unfortunately, the census was not happened in 2021. If the census happened, then we could have get more better picture of this the population, especially the Meitei-Kuki community who have came to Manipur in the past 10 to 15 years. As per our analysis, it is around 4 lakhs. Such a huge number in the past 10 to 15 years they have entered to Manipur. Okay, now, in terms of the land, yes, this Meitei, they are allowed to leave only this 10% of the land, okay? And the other community, the which are in the scheduled tribe, they can live in the 90% of the total land area of Manipur. Okay, now, Meitei, yes, we have a problem of the land scarcity. But the important is that today the Meitei is not only the one which is basically we are talking about the land reformation. For the Meitei, it is a matter of survival. Meitei in their own homeland in Manipur facing many challenges because of the growing population from the other community. There is a change of demography. And in the Imphal Valley, one may say that there are huge, you know, the buildings, the markets, the business, the tradings are there, which is probably people may assume that that is controlled by the Meitei. Definitely not. 90-95% of the business are controlled by the non-Meiteis. And in this 10% land, again, if you see there, every community can live there. Okay, now it is not the land reformation which Meitei are seeking. The Meitei, for their survival, we are demanding the scheduled tribe status, because there is a very valid reason, because the Meiteis, they are living in Manipur, and there is no other place where there is a substantial population of Meitei where they can tell to the world that, okay, there is also another second home for the Meitei. No, if Meitei extinct from Manipur, then the Meitei will extinct forever from the world also. So that's why Meitei are demanding for the scheduled tribe status for their survival.
Thank you, Nabakishore ji. The reason why I brought up this land thing is because, as you just mentioned, that the tribes which are scheduled tribe currently, they can come into the valley and they can settle and do business. But the Meitei people from the valley are not allowed to go into the hills and set up. And the Meiteis are now facing a problem of shortage of land and resources because of this encroachment by the hill area people. And therefore, they are wanting this scheduled tribe status so that they can have the same privileges as these people have, because that is unfortunately how the constitution has been set up, and they are demanding very legitimately. I've heard from Shri Pramod Singh, who is also a Meitei leader in Manipur. He said that there are Meitei people living in Bangladesh. Could you throw some light on this issue, that there are other people in Bangladesh, the Meitei people in Bangladesh and neighboring areas also?
Meiteis are not living only in Bangladesh. Meitei are living in Assam also. Meitei are living in Myanmar also. Okay, now the Meitei living in Myanmar, they are also, the Kukis are also living in Myanmar. Okay. Now, the same, the Kukis are also found to be living in Bangladesh. Now, the same Kuki also found to be living in Assam. And Mizoram, if you talk about, that is the entire state where this Kuki, there another families, like they call in the a group, like a Chin, Kuki, Chao, Mijo. So the Mizoram, it's like they are another kind of the home state. Okay. Now, for the Meitei, we do not have any difficulty living in Bangladesh. We do not have any difficulty living in Assam, or we don't see any difficulty living in Myanmar as well. Okay. So I'm not sure in what kind of information or statement given by the Sri Pramodji, because I have not heard of that. I have not gone through that, his interview. As per but again, if you talk about the whole population of Meitei all across the world, that could stand around 17 to 17.5 lakhs, because around 15 lakhs we say that Meitei population in Manipur, and around 1.7 lakhs in Assam, and the Bangladesh could be few thousands, and also Myanmar also could be few thousands. So putting all together, it could be around 17.5 or maybe 18 lakhs. Okay, but if you look into the kind of the total population of the Kuki, that could be around 40 to 45 lakhs. And please remember that Myanmar, when the democracy was there, there were two member of parliament, the Chin Kuki community represented, two Chin Kuki leader represented in their member of parliament. So that kind of the presence the Chin Kuki have even in the Myanmar. But for the Meitei, they are very minuscule, very minority in Myanmar.
Thank you, Nabakishore ji, for clarifying that. Now, I've also heard that there is an apex body of these tribes in Manipur, which has petitioned the center and state government many a times to remove these Kukis from the ST list, because that kind of leads to more infiltration.
What you mentioned is, I think, okay, before answering to that question, or I try to answer that question, in the list of scheduled tribe, as per the Constitution of India, Kuki as a tribe name is not mentioned in Manipur, interestingly. Okay. However, Kuki as a scheduled tribe in the scheduled tribe list have been mentioned in Assam, in Meghalaya, in Mizoram. Okay. Now, this apex body, I think there is a sub clans are there. I think this is, I think Thado, they have, I think, claimed this. Okay. But the question now it comes that the scheduled tribe is a privilege given by the Constitution of India to protect the indigenous community. However, being immigrant in Manipur, how come a Chin Kuki community can get this privilege of scheduled tribe? So that question is also there. So we can see that there are lots of faults from the government side. They have not investigated properly whom to give this scheduled tribe, whom not to give, who are indigenous, who are not indigenous, who are deprived, who are not deprived. Okay. So there are so many issues. Okay. And today, because of all these issues, okay, we are facing this kind of crisis. And it is obvious, it is the law of nature. Wherever there is injustice happened, then definitely there won't be peace. So justice should precede peace. So today, the Meitei feels that it is an injustice to the entire community, which the Meitei supposed to get there as a rightful, the citizen of Manipur, where the Meitei king has ruled there many years. In fact, National Archive of Delhi, they have proven that one of our manuscripts called Wakoklon, they have proved that it is around 3,400 years ago that manuscript was written. And you just think today that Meitei, who ruled that the kingdom as a kingdom, and today they are just confined in the 10% of the land. Okay. So the whole point is the justice should be given to Meitei, as I said, then only the long term, the peace will come or maintain in Manipur.
Thank you, Nabakishoreji, for giving that detailed answer. Now, the next question I'd like to ask is that what is this problem of the illegal immigration or encroachment or infiltration, I would like to say, the insurgency which is happening in Manipur, and what is the whole relation with the Kukis and Meiteis? So could you throw light on that? What is this whole insurgency infiltration issue?
If you see the insurgency problem in Northeast, it is not new. If you talk about Assam, if you talk about the Tripura, and lots of other such states even in the India, the insurgency issue almost the states they have faced. Now, the problem is particularly in this Kuki is that it looks like the entire community, they support this insurgency activity. I think I have gone through many of the interviews or the debate talks in the media. Even there are publication, be it the professors of JNU or the professor of the Hyderabad University who belongs to Kuki community, or the very much elected the legislators, the 10 MLAs of Manipur, they talk about the same language. They talk about the same language that they justify that the poppy cultivation done by this illegal immigrant, their brothers or the sisters are justified, and telling that government is not providing enough alternative livelihood for them. And the entire, if you see the government, if you talk about the central government, are they taking any action enough? I don't think. Okay. So I think for me, it's a total surprise. Okay. They speak the same language of protecting their illegal immigrant community who indulge in this poppy cultivation, who indulge in this producing the heroin, and maybe they are selling out across the country or maybe outside the country. Okay, they are supporting the militancy. Okay, and today they claim that they want a separate administration. Okay, so it's not a surprise. And why the rest of the country of our Indian fellows outside of Manipur, they are not even trying to understand. They are taking kind of the impression that this violence is between a minority versus majority. Some of them, in fact, trying to color that this is a Christian versus the Hindu conflict. Even the Meitei-Kuki community, they are sending to United Nations that this is a persecution by the Meitei to them, and even they are giving their religious kind of flavor. And why the government is silent? Why they are not putting all this activities they're involving in all this illegal activity? Why they have not put into the behind the bar? So this is very surprise.
That's very, very disheartening and sad to hear, Nabakishore ji. The Meitei people have been demanding for the NRC. How does that help in this? Could you elaborate on that?
NRC is a mechanism to identify the people who have come to the state or to the country illegally. The government of Manipur, they have initiated that the cutoff year, in the beginning, they have proposed the cutoff year to be 1951. But then again, the same hue and cry from this Meitei-Kuki community that no, the cutoff year should be the 1961. Why? Had the Meitei objected that the cutoff year should not be 1951 or 1961 or 71? Had the other indigenous community, did they object? Then why they had to object? Why not 1951? Okay, now the NRC is something which government had set up a kind of a process where the illegal immigrants can be identified, and the government will do the necessary steps to this illegally entered to this country. Okay, so we feel that is the one kind of process to help to identify these illegal people, but that is not the whole solution. The whole solution is what I said already. For the Meitei, we want the scheduled tribe status to be given, and that is not something new. During the British time in the 1936, there was a tribal census initiated by the British in the 1936, and they identified the Meitei as a forest tribe. Okay, so whatever the criteria as specified by the government, be it the Lokur committee criteria, be it the Pandas committee criteria, how a community can claim a scheduled tribe. So Meitei fulfills that. And for the past 10 years, the Meitei had been struggling, requesting to the government. Sometimes we did some sort of dharna agitation to send these two reports. One is the latest socioeconomic report, and another is the ethnographic report of Meitei to the Ministry of Tribal Affairs. And for the past 10 years, that has not been sent. So what is left to us is to seek the door of the court that why the government is not sending these reports. And simply we did that. Then why the Kuki had to burn down the houses of Meitei, starting in Churachandpur and starting at the same time in Moray? Why this kind of hooligans they made it? Do they think that by indulging the the drug business or indulging to this militancy, they are having the superpower. It's not fair, right? It's not fair.
It somehow repeats of a pattern that was followed in Kashmir. And I'm just very, very scared that the Meiteis don't become the Kashmiri Pandits of Kashmir. It's actually very, very scary. And I've also read that the Kukis also had problems with the Naga people and with the Meitei people. So they are basically, as you said, the British said that they are barbaric and they are very violent. So they definitely, I mean, it's a failure of the law and order and the governments to protect the Meiteis. It's very, very sad. And the least they can do is provide the scheduled tribe status. Now, Nabakishore ji, what ramifications of this violence and this issue of insurgency has on the neighboring northeast states?
The first and foremost, what I see personally, the violence is definitely an outcome of their misdeeds. They have destroyed the entire ecosystem. They indulged in producing the drugs, and that definitely make a mayhem to the even the neighboring state of Assam. You may find it lots of claims or the lots of the reports from the government of Assam also. The chief minister of Assam is struggling to control the menace of the drugs. Why all this suddenly start increased? Okay, now coming to this violence, if the Sh-Nabakishore community, they live respecting the laws of the land, respecting the constitution, the respecting the spirit of the democracy of the country, definitely there will be peace. Like many other community, we are living, like there are lots of Meiteis are living in Assam. Do you find any kind of report that there were kind of a violence? No, because the people who live there, they respect the law of the land. Okay, as long as you respect law of the land, why there will be any kind of this kind of the riots or the violence? So that they have to understand. They just simply cannot do whatever they want. If you think that this community with this violence which is happening currently with the Meitei, maybe it may resolve over the time, maybe sooner time. Do you think that such violence will not repeat again in the Manipur? There is a high chance, because there is already an indication given by the Naga community. You must have noticed that one of the civil society organization from Naga, they have claimed that the territories or the areas which you claim that it belongs to you, I mean to Kuki, those lands belongs to Naga. You can't claim. So you don't see kind of a chain reaction. So the government of India must consider this Manipur's problem as a bigger problem, just like a problem which happened in Kashmir. Why Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji is not uttering a single word about Manipur violence? Why Honorable Home Minister Amit Shah ji took almost 24 days to visit Manipur? And there were serious issues. The issue is not about only a violence between the two community. The issue is deep rooted where all these illegal activities were happening in the state. I hope I made my point to you.
There has been a systematic penetration and kind of a production of Meitei hatred by the politicians and the intellectuals in Manipur systematically since many decades now. So they're trying to promote hatred against the Meiteis by making them into Hindus and, you know, this and that, all those kind of things. What do you think the role of this hatred promoted by politicians and intellectuals over the decades has contributed also to this mindset?
This point, I do not fully agree that any politicians made such efforts. Okay, and if I talk about this kind of hatred or kind of this, probably what I see is the only one community who probably this Meitei-Kuki community, with a vision that they want a separate administration, they want a separate state out of the Manipur state, and with that objective probably they could have been working, and there could be that they have been telling to their other community people, the kind of the civilians, brainwashing them, telling that the Meiteis being a majority, they are doing kind of the persecution, they are doing kind of the exploitation. But it is not like that. If you ask any community who are living in Churachandpur area, be a Meitei or be a trading community who came from the mainland of India, you ask with them, or probably those are visible now in many interviews, that there are extortions. I think monthly, the businessmen who are doing in Churachandpur, they have to pay some money to these militants. Okay, just such a ridiculous.
Amit Shahji has said that they'll set up a judicial committee and they have deployed troops there. What is the situation on ground right now?
Yes, Tanya ji. So during that visit of Amit Shahji, I was also there in that all CSO leaders meet. I presented our concerns and also the kind of the demand which Meitei needs. After leaving Amit Shah, or after his visit, he had a press conference there. He announced for a judicial inquiry. At the same time, there also will be a CBI inquiry for some 6 cases. The violence, I think, were there after his visit also, but I think for the past 2 to 3 days, I think the situation is much better. Now, from the government of India side, they have not told any specific what they will do or what they will not do on the kind of the demands, spared even an inch of land from Manipur to anyone. So we believe that the demand put by the Meitei-Kuki community for separate administration, I think it will not happen. At the same time, if the government is considering for any other alternative things, then I think it is not only the Meitei, it is also the Naga community. They will also put that their cookies demand. It will not be that easy. The Naga is also going to oppose. Now, for the judicial inquiry, that will be done by the retired Chief Justice of High Court, Mr. Ajay Lambaji, along with one retired IPS and retired IS in that committee. But what Meitei, or we as a World Meitei Council, we shall demand this inquiry to be done as a court monitored, so that there is a fair and transparent inquiry should be done for this violence.
And we've also been hearing these news about how the president's rule should be kind of put on Manipur, and Article 355 is set. Do you think that will help temporarily to get a solution to this till the time the solution is found? What are your suggestions?
I do not think that there is a need of precedent rule. The action has to be done on this Sioux militants who are openly, they are coming out and involved in this violence. Even the some data comes out, they are saying that these militants, they have returned to the camp with only 50%. Then what are these rest 42% doing? If these militants are controlled by the government, I think the peace will be restored, the normalcy to the people's life in Manipur will come back. And I don't think the president rule will give any solution at this moment.
Thank you so much, Nabakishore ji. And I just wanted to ask, are there any reports as to in this riots and violence, what is the number of deaths or injuries of the Meiteis versus the Kukis? Just for because I don't see those kind of figures anywhere. Do you have any news about that?
No, I also don't have any such data. So we do not have any figure community-wise. And I would like to say here that with the numbers or with the figures, even in the future, if government shares any kind of such reports, I'm not going to go with this kind of interpretation that who is in the receiving mode. This violence, we should look into from this angle that who started this violence and what was the intention of this violence? Let this judicial inquiry come out with the proper root cause, and it will be transparent. As today, Meitei claims that the violence was started by them and it was claimed through the various evidences. That's all from my side.
Thank you so much, Nabakishore ji, for coming on Sangam Talks and sharing your experience, your very, very nuanced and articulate analysis on the ground, and your leadership for the Meitei people is amazing. And we hope you keep doing that. And we really hope and we petition the government, union, and state, please don't let Manipur become another Kashmir. And don't let the Meitei people become another Kashmiri Pandit. Please don't repeat it. We really request that you intervene timely and get this issue sorted. And there is an honest investigation and action taken, strict action taken against the culprits. With that, we thank you. Namaste.
Thank you. Thank you, Tanya ji. And thank you, Sangam Talks, for inviting me to this show so that the rest of the country or the world should know what is actual is happening in Manipur and what was the root cause. That we should and everyone should know for the better future. Thank you.